The Beetle Dune is the regular beetle's ruggedized cousin, with a mild lift and a unique appearance package meant to evoke Baja bugs, dune buggies, Francis Herbert sci-fi novels. Incidentally, it's just about the most expensive beetle in the lineup, with a starting price of $27,685. In addition to side cladding, new front and rear fascias and a 0.55-inch increase in ride height, the Dune gets special 18-inch Canyon alloy wheels and Dune decals just above the rocker panels. A 6-speed automatic is the only transmission choice, and a 174 HP 2.0-liter Turbo 4 is the only available motor. The assumption that the Volkswagen Beetle circa 2018 makes is that the charm that cemented its mid-century namesake status as an automotive icon is largely a result of aesthetics: the rounded shape, the smiling face, etc. Because that's basically what this new Beetle, not to be confused with its direct predecessor, the new Beetle, is, visually, a bigger, tubbier but surprisingly faithful facsimile of the original, at least until you start to dig beneath the surface. But while the original bug was indeed very cute, it became an icon because it was beautifully simple. As with the Model T, there was something wonderful about how much it did with so little. And sure, it was basically built forever and wound up seemingly everywhere. Longevity and ubiquity never hurt when you're trying to drill something into the popular consciousness. By virtue of being a water-cooled, front-engined car that trades style for function and sits a rung or two above entry-level territory, this Beetle and by extension, its variants like the Beetle Dune is not so much a true successor to the Bug as it is, if you want to be cynical, an attempt to cash in on the warm and fuzzy feelings we all still hold toward it. In this sense it reminds me of the new Porsche 911 Targa. The form is there, but the modern-day function is so far removed from the elegance of the original that something very significant is lost. 2019 Volkswagen Beetle Final Edition First Drive. However, this isn't the first time Volkswagen has put the bug on the product chopping block. In the US, Volkswagen pulled. That said, the present Beetle is not an objectively bad car. For obvious reasons, a rear-mounted air-cooled engine wouldn't fly today. The modest, economical 2.0-liter turbo feels fairly appropriate. It certainly isn't overpowered, but it's smooth and torquey enough to scoot the Neo Bug around without drama. Unfortunately, there's no manual option, which is especially baffling considering the bare-bones Econocar it supposedly pays tribute to. It doesn't drive poorly, it shares its bones with the MK6 Golf, after all, which is by no means a bad place to start. This is what you'd probably call a style-forward car, so I see it appealing to a crowd that won't mind that it uses previous generation underpinnings anyway. No, the Beetle's biggest problem is philosophical. That goes doubly for the Dune, which is apparently supposed to recall the Baja conquering Beetles of yore but offers no tangible connection to those buggies aside from a name and a nominal half-inch increase in ride height. Honestly, the Golf has surpassed the Beetle as an all-around affordable, useful, fun-to-drive people's car, and unless you never routinely tote more than one passenger, the Beetle can't be the only car in your fleet. And if you really want to add a Beetle to your garage, why not just get an old one? They're not exactly expensive. Ever since the pent-up baby boomer demand for a comparatively luxurious echo of the bugs of their youth was sated, there was probably some demand from younger neo-bohemians who craved the look but not the grease under their fingernails. The new Beetle has been searching for a reason to exist. Which it won't, for very much longer. A-Look's final edition is going to see it out the door in the next model year. So if you see something you like in the Beetle Dune, or any other Beetle for that matter, act fast, because this won't be available for much longer.